having Trumpie on because he could really take a punch. I mean, there wasn't anything. I was asking him about being married to Marla Maples, and he said, if you're interested, I'll give you her phone number. It was just, it was all Trump all the time. So then he started messing around with the birther and how did a guy like Barack Obama get into Columbia? How did a guy like him get into Harvard? And these questions, and it wasn't an original thought to myself. I heard other people smarter than myself break down the innuendo of that, the nuance of what he was talking about. And then we got to talking about it one night on the show without Trumpie, and I said, well, if he's a racist, maybe we shouldn't invite him on the show. Being full well-meaning that if he is in fact a racist. So then I had to call Don because he wasn't coming back on the show. And I said, Don, I don't think you're a racist because I think you're too smart. I said, I think smart people are not racists. And he said, well, of course, I'm smart. I'm not a racist. I said, well, there you go. You've proven my point. So come back and be on the show. And he came back and he was on the show two or three times after that. And I thought the deal was done. I thought, okay, I called him out. He's too smart to be a racist. He said, yeah, I'm too smart to be a racist. Well, I was wrong.
Right. He's clearly a racist now.
Well, I'll tell you, and I said this the other day talking to a kid from the New York Times. In the beginning, and we've heard Trump running for president over and over again, and we always thought, and it would be good fun. And then he opens up and he talks about the building the wall and the evil people coming from Mexico and wherever else. And when that happened, I thought, okay, this will take care of Donald. He's done there. Or at the very least, somebody will say, Don, we need to talk to you a little bit about what you said regarding Mexicans. Just don't hit that so hard next time. You know, I thought if he was really in it, somebody with some brains would, but that didn't happen. And then the next thing that I found unconscionable, actually unconscionable, was he physically mocked a man who was a reporter from the New York Times who suffers, I believe, a congenital birth defect. And I just thought, forget it's Donald Trump, forget he's running for president, forget who he is, forget what he is, man or woman.